Good morning, Half Moon Bay High School. This is the Cougar Campus News. Seniors, please complete the mandatory survey for this year's graduation slideshow ASAP. Check for an email from Ms. Lundstroth with a link titled Mandatory Senior Graduation Survey. Seniors, do you want to look good on stage at graduation? Did you earn a B or better in any art class during your high school career? If you answered yes to the previous two questions, did you know that you are eligible to join the National Art Honor Society and have earned the right to wear the rainbow cord at graduation? So, if you want to look good and show off your accomplishments in the visual arts, please send an email to Mr. Reardon to sign up for your rainbow honor cord. Now it's time for Female Friday as we continue to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Title IX. Here's Kehlani and Olivia with today's report.
The female that we are honoring today is Rigoberta Menchú.
Menchú was born on January 9, 1959 into a poor indigenous family that was very involved with K'iche branch of Mayan culture.
When she was just a young teenage girl, Menchú took on a role in women's rights and the social reforms movement.
In 1979, she joined the committee of the Peasant Union and taught herself several languages, including English, Spanish, and many other Mayan languages when her native language was K'iche.
In 1980, she was a prominent leader in the strike for better working conditions for farmers on the Pacific Coast and took on a role of educating the native peasants that were not given the same schooling opportunities as others.
Menchú eventually went on to being the organizer of the resistance to stop oppression in Guatemala and fight for native rights.
Menchú is known for being a female advocate for Native American rights, ethno-cultural reconciliation, and for standing up for female workers.
In 1992, she won a Nobel Peace Prize for all the work that she did for the Western Hemisphere and the rest of the world.
Thank you for joining us on Female Friday, and we hope you have a good Friday, Cougars.
This weekend, Environmental Club will be planting native plants and painting waste bins from 10 to 2 on Saturday and Sunday. Everyone is welcome and you can earn service hours. Don't forget, today at lunch in the quad is the job fair. Now, here's Ms. Hoffman from Real Life Learning with this special announcement.
Hey Cougars! Thanks to all 522 of you who took the Career Day survey after last week's video. We had a tie for most class participation. Miss Jansen's first period class and Mr. Toner's seventh period class were the lucky winners. Not lucky, you worked for it. So thanks for participating. Those teachers have been emailed about scheduling the donut party. And now the lucky six students winners for taking the survey are Noah Alger, Maya Johnson, Eli Wilson, Chelsea Solorio, Kian Murphy, and Jade Ireland. Congrats, come find me in the quad today during job fair to pick up your Starbucks gift cards. See all of you at lunchtime today for job fair. Take care.
Okay, right now, it's time now for the news about the boys' varsity baseball team and the girls' gymnastics team.
The varsity baseball team defeated Woodside 14-2 yesterday afternoon. Ryan Harrington started on the mound and earned the win with 5 strikeouts. William Moffitt led the offense with 2 extra base hits, including a double and a triple. Moffitt scored 2 runs and drove 3 RBIs. Trevor Corcini delivered 2 hits and 3 RBIs. Liam Harrington collected 2 hits with a double, 2 runs scored, and an RBI. Kai Zanetti had a 2-run single and scored 2 runs. Devin Costa closed out the game with 3 shutout innings pitched and 3 strikeouts. Let's check out some of the highlights.
Thank you.
The Hoffman Bay High School gymnastics team crushed their second meet this past Wednesday. The varsity team not only took home the win as a team overall, but also won every single event. Varsity members Josie Kearns and Jaya Miller competed for Half Moon Bay for the first time this season. Both put up great performances, adding to the team's victory with Josie showcasing a beautiful 9.35 vault that earned her gold, and Jaya taking the win on bars and in the all-around. Cameron Tobias added to their winning streak, getting first place on beam and floor, scoring a 9.7 on both. Michaela Sandino and Asia Tsutsumi both contributed to the team win, upgrading their routines to respectively score a 9.55 and a 9.2 on floor, with very strong performances on all other events. JV members Zayana Hernandez and Diana Castaneda worked hard to upgrade and perfect their routines, Zayana taking home the silver on vault and Diana putting up a solid performance, including showcasing her beam routine for the first time. Follow the gymnastics team at the Instagram below. Go Cougars!